Good morning, Congress. The people here, still seeing something and saying something. Well, you've been ramping it up this week so far, haven't you? First thing Monday morning, we're treated to the latest in a long line of contrived events. What tells us it's contrived? Well, there were the three news reports that show up online on a Sunday timestamp for an event which didn't occur until the next morning, but that's not it. The simple explanation of an original story being superimposed over a previous URL for a different story and then picked up by the two other news outlets is actually plausible this time, but only this time. That does not get you off the hook for the multiple Sandy Hook websites, all different and not affiliated, being put up days before the event. No, it isn't just those stories which tell us this is just more sick homicidal fakery designed to distract. What it is the common thread in all your theatrical productions. There's always a lone male shooter with a serious mental history who ends up dead or whisked away not to be heard from again. There are always psychotropic drugs and/or violent video games involved, and claims of semi-automatic weapons causing the whole thing, or some twisted religious ideology, or some combination of all of those things. Too bad you really screwed up on this one this time, because there wasn't a semi-automatic weapon anywhere within the perimeter of the scene, even though you kept having your puppet press report that there was. No, we know because we're watching you, your MO, time after time, the hints you give us leading up to it. You know, like planned drills, Sandy Hook, Boston, etc. Announcements of perceived threats to the president or the public, shadowy terrorist plans, you name it. It never fails. The signs are always there beforehand, but you just keep getting sloppier and sloppier. Or are you just getting scared shitless that we're coming for you? Actually, hold on to that thought. It just could turn out to be healthy. Yesterday, while the nation was paying attention to the orchestrated distraction at the Naval Yard in D.C., there was a very important event taking place. The Citizens Commission on Benghazi. The archive of the testimony and question and answer sessions are not yet posted, and the next video in this series will deal with that in its entirety. However, the last speaker had some exponentially important information to share. Larry Ward of politicalmedia.com testified at the commission, and some of the points he had to share are absolutely imperative if America is ever to gain the truth in regard to Benghazi, Fast and Furious, Extortion 17, or any other swept under the rug scandal. It seems there are 8 members of Congress called the Super 8 that have the top clearance, same as the President of the United States. John Boehner is one of them. Anybody like to guess who the other 7 might be? However, every member of Congress, by virtue of getting elected, have the right to the top clearance, the same as the president. But the House also has the power to funnel that down to a select number of members. There are 535 members of the House and Senate, and only 8 have that clearance. So this begs the question, how is Congress supposed to represent us if they don't have all the facts? How are they supposed to represent our interests if only 8 of them know what's happened? And how are those 8 members supposed to digest all of the classified information, especially the glut of classified information that we've seen happen just since 2008? He's not saying Boehner knows what happened or that he's complicit in what happened, nor that he is protecting someone. What he is saying is that John Boehner had access to that data, and he should have known. And if something nefarious was going on, he should have stopped it. So, either he's protecting someone he knows, himself, or some other organization. That's why he will not form the select committee to investigate Benghazi. There can be 434 signatures on the House resolution for the Watergate-style select committee, and Boehner is not going to do it. So the only way around that roadblock is the Steve Stotman discharge petition to force the resolution to the floor for a vote. We the people have to push loudly, unremittingly, to force our representatives to sign that discharge petition. That's what we can do. They aren't going to want to, because they are being threatened by Boehner with political retribution if they sign. In fact, one congressman, when Mr. Stotman introduced the petition, leaned over and said, "Really, Steve? A discharge petition? Ha! They'll never find your body. Ha ha ha." Well, that pretty much outlines how our country's being run behind our backs, but in front of our eyes. And it's time we clean house with a vengeance. Even though what I've just said indicates that only 8 are potentially aiding in the cover-up of high crimes and treasonous nature, for which high-level people in our government should be tried, convicted, and summarily executed, they are all guilty of crimes against our Constitution. They all play the game. You scratch my back and I'll scratch yours. You grease my palm and I'll vote for your bill. Let's all vote for a measure to grant ourselves immunity from the laws we pass by selling our votes. Yes, they are, every one of them, criminals. But it would appear that only 8 are actively covering up high treason and in collusion with it. The rest of them must be forced to do the job we sent them there to do or be removed. Fox News has obtained a draft report from the House Oversight and Government Reform Committee, which alleges that the Obama administration's internal review of the Benghazi terrorist attack scandal was a farce designed to provide cover for the Obama administration. The report says that the Obama-ordered review of how the Benghazi terrorist attack took place and why there was a cover-up was neither comprehensive or thorough and was damaged by conflicts of interest. Absolutely no surprise there. In short, the Obama administration continues to cover up the truth behind the Benghazi attack. Why no help was sent once our diplomats and CIA agents came under attack, and why the Obama administration has not fessed up about the allegations that the Benghazi mission was about supplying arms and training for Syrian rebels, who really are terrorists and are aligned with Al-Qaeda. Obama thinks he can get away with the lies and the cover-up, but with your help, we are continuing to push for the truth to be told. You, America, you must help. New polls show the American public no longer trusts Barack Obama's handling of foreign policy issues, and the Benghazi scandal is one of the most compelling reasons why. Explain to us, Congress, just how it is you are doing the job we sent you to do on both sides of the aisle, and yet all you're doing and all you have done is continually attack America's freedom in a frantic attempt to abolish all constitutionally protected, God-bestowed human rights. You're not doing that, you say? Really? Let's take a look at a few of the items you've been hell-bent to accomplish, shall we? Medical history databases, Obamacare. Death panels, Obamacare. forcing deadly vaccines on the people and the children. Obamacare. The gun grab. Obamacare. Yeah, you think we don't know about that one? Not gonna work. Declare us crazy, we shoot you, and then we have the perfect insanity defense. Well, that's brilliant. By the way, we the people do not recognize executive orders as law, and we have no intention of abiding by them. In fact, we have no intention of abiding by anything you've produced in the last 5 years, because we no longer recognize you as fit to make decisions which affect this nation or any other nation. You are truly neutered by your handlers, disrespected by us, and rightly so, and absolutely worthless to anybody in your current state. Mass genocide through agricultural poisoning, Monsanto, and fluoridated water, toothpaste, and dental treatments. Of course, that also has a nice little side effect you like so much, in that it renders people more docile. Too bad we figured that one out and no longer drink the water or use your commercial products on our teeth, much less on the teeth of our children. There's total silence in the halls of government when this administration makes statements like, our children are not ours to raise as we see fit as parents. Maybe you baboons think your kids are better off in indoctrination centers, and while we'll concede that if your prowess as leaders is any indication of your ability to parent, that might actually be true in your case. But you do not decide for us how to parent or who will parent, and you certainly do not decide for us what constitutes educating our children. Amnesty for millions of criminals, and yes, they are criminals, when they break the law to come here. Immigration. Pushing us to accept another war for the bankers, otherwise known as your puppet masters. Creating false flag events, and don't even try to deny that one, in order to disarm us. Authoritarian control of the internet. Fairness doctrine. Executive orders. Who knows what all you think you're going to come up with next. That's not going to work either. Stopping free speech. Your current bill on defining journalists shows you with your pants down around your ankles, people. Spying on every one of us in every aspect of our lives, using the NSA, all major internet providers, email providers, and using the IRS to attack those of us who object to being victimized for your thieving agenda and sold on the open market to your global misery profiteers. Scripted and staged news using crisis actors, both here and abroad. You've been busted for that too many times to count now. Apparently, you really do think we're stupid. We now see every single event that happens, which gives you more fodder for the gun grab rhetoric to be just like the boy who cried wolf. We aren't affected the way you think we are. Stupid stunts, like using drugs and violent video games to incite some whacked out veteran whose mind you've already destroyed by the reality of what is going on in the Middle East, only serve to strengthen our resolve to eliminate every one of you from your positions. Funny, while most of us don't put much faith in anything David Wilcox says, he sure hit it on the nose with this one, didn't he? Last night, I drove to a place where I could use my phone and talk to one of my top insiders for over an hour. This is the same insider who recently said, every time the Ponzi scheme known as the Federal Reserve Note is about to collapse, they need another mass catastrophe to prop it back up again. Last night I said, now that Syria fell through, they're going to have to cook up something else to try to distract the headlines and create fear and trauma. You know, like another mass shooting. Little did I realize that it would happen the very next day. We find it most interesting that every time you pull off one of these events, in order to attempt to instill fear and gain compliance with your gun grab, the shooter ends up dead or permanently mentally unfit to speak. What a hat trick! But we aren't buying it. Mr. Wilcock points out the very real possibility of using hypnosis, and we agree that everyone should watch the shocking TV show by Darren Brown, where he actually does hypnotize an individual to kill the actor Stephen Fry, and the guy actually does it, even though the gun is loaded with blanks. Outright theft of property through fraudulent foreclosures in order to hand over all property to the UN sick New World Order. Now you want our sexual information. This is one perverted creep nobody would want to find in their bed, and we can tell you that goes for all the rest of you too. You have the Supreme Court declare you only have newly interpreted limited protection under the Fifth Amendment. Guess that doesn't apply to Lois Lerner, does it? AP history books teaching our children rewritten text of our founding documents. Can we say indoctrination to accept slavery, boys and girls? Well, guess what? We're going to teach our kids out of the real Constitution. So good try. You're turning a blind eye to the witnesses from Benghazi being coerced into silence and suspended as if they, when they refuse to sign an NDA. You're refusing to sign the discharge petition to force the vote to the floor on a Watergate-style select committee. Why? Simple. John Boehner is threatening you with political backlash or retaliation if you sign. Guess what, nitwits? The political backlash and retaliation is going to come down on your heads tenfold come the next election if you don't sign it. You've all allowed John Boehner to threaten and coerce you into hushing up and abandoning the Fast and Furious investigation. You're all bowing down to a system of governance that is so far removed from our constitutional republic, we can't even give it a name. You're afraid to buck leadership? Have you totally lost your minds? Have any of you ever read the Constitution? Hell, you only need to read Article 1 to understand that you don't answer to the Speaker of the House, the President, the Senate, or any other so-called government leadership. You answer to us. And when you're being prohibited from doing the job we sent you there to do, you need to come to us. You need to expose the corruption. We aren't bound by John Boehner's rules or Obama's bid for first official dictator. Get that? You do not get that John Boehner cannot reelect you. Do you not get that you will be held 100% accountable for the blatant crimes you are committing against the people of this nation each and every day when you allow this sick administration and the global agenda to wipe out this country's freedom and liberty? What in the Sam hell are you smoking? You sit there like stone baboons while the White House states outright lies in a press conference, like claiming the overwhelming majority of the people support gun control. That indicates collusion in the fascist takeover, idiots. You don't get to vote absent, or we'll make you absent. You will start representing the real voices of the people, or you won't be representing anything but your dog, if he or she will allow it. And we even doubt that. You take part in the lunatic attempts to get the American people to back World War III with us starting it. On what? Gas attacks in Syria, which have been going on for months, and Obama was fully aware of, in a civil war that's none of our damn business in the first place. Do you honestly think you can convince us that death by gas attack is worse than being blown apart by an RPG or dismembered by a cannibal who's being armed by Obama? You sit there and think you're going to be left out of the roundup when the time comes to prosecute, convict, and execute those responsible for the death and destruction you are so casually taking part in? Are you so completely out of touch with reality that you think we don't know our money is being extorted from us by you to arm the very terrorists the FBI warns us are planning to attack us, and you will just skip off into la-la land unscathed? That's the problem with baboons. They like to bare their teeth and beat their chest, but at the end of the day, they're just lower life forms after all. Many of you have the monumental audacity to proclaim you are Christians while you watch and take part in Christians being mutilated, tortured, and burned in the Middle East by the very animals you're using our money, which you steal from us, to arm. You don't say a word when the Obama administration declares war on Christians using the DHS and the military to do it. You go along with imbecilic Supreme Court decisions barring the free exercise of our national heritage and your supposed religion in favor of genocidal jihadist Islam. And as long as we're on that subject, let's hear the words from the Common Sense Show on Sunday, September 15th. They will be the most hunted people on the planet. Posted on September 16th, 2013. From the Common Sense Show by Dave Hodges. It is becoming apparent that Christians, and American Christians in particular, will soon become the most hunted people on the face of the earth. The coming persecution will make the Romans' persecution of the Christians seem tame compared to what is coming. Department of Homeland Security policies and their subsequent actions have become an effective barometer from which to judge the direction of the tyrannical takeover of our government by the central bankers and what it will ultimately mean for Christians. Let the crucifixions begin. Christians face court-martial for sharing faith in Obama's military. DHS is lining itself up against Christians. The army is lining itself up against Christians. Obama has always been against Christians. As supreme commander of the military, Obama has encouraged and permitted the United States military to participate in the persecution of Christians. A recent army briefing given by Lieutenant Colonel Jack Rich to a reserve unit in Pennsylvania identified several organizations and movements as extremist groups. First on the list of his slides presented in the briefing listed Evangelical Christians, and the list also included Catholics, Hamas, Al-Qaeda, Nation of Islam, and the Ku Klux Klan. Isn't it comforting to realize that your government sees Catholic and evangelical Christians in the same light as Hamas, Al-Qaeda, and the Klan? Lieutenant Colonel Rich warned his subordinates to not back down from, quote, bad Christian behavior, unquote, for, quote, when they see behaviors which are inconsistent with army values, don't just walk by, do the right thing before it becomes a problem, unquote. What exactly constitutes bad Christian behavior? Is praying a bad Christian behavior? Further, the warning has been given to flag Christians and put them on no-buy lists for guns. Rich's briefing dovetails with the same kind of anti-Christian rhetoric recently presented to Colorado law enforcement officials in La Junta, Colorado, in which Christians were prominently displayed as domestic terrorists if they take the Bible too literally. Of course, Christians take the Bible literally. This is why Christians read and study the Bible. The Word of God is not a comic book. It is the Bible. And as such, all Christians have just been declared to be enemies of the state. Below is a screenshot of a page out of Rich's anti-Christian PowerPoint presentation. Please note the repeated references to various types of Christians. Interestingly, I did not see the official religion of the United Nations, Gaia, listed as a domestic terror group. Look at the last item on the list, Islamophobia. Isn't it telling that Christianophobia is not listed as an area of concern, thus making it clear that the government only sees Christians as the problem and never the potential victim? This is precisely the point. At the risk of beating a dead horse, your central banker hijacked government has just told you that you Christians are an identified enemy of the state. You Christians are not an enemy of the state because you might plant an IED in a public place. You Christians are not an enemy of the state because you support terrorism. You Christians are an enemy of the state because you are Christians and you possess spiritual weapons which could dismantle the entire New World Order. The consequence for being an enemy of the state. Coptic children are forced to leave their families and convert to Islam because the law says Muslims are better than Christians. Why should the eventual fate of American Christians be any different? In Egypt, Libya, and Syria, the Muslim Brotherhood was installed as a new leadership or rebel leadership with the help of the Obama administration. These groups are also aligned with Al-Qaeda. These groups are killing Christians by the thousands in all three countries. Presently, the Muslim Brotherhood and Al-Qaeda are persecuting Egyptian Coptic Christians in horrific ways, and Obama hears no evil and sees no evil. It is notable that the Coptic Christian presence in Egypt predates the Muslim. However, to the Muslim Brotherhood, Al-Qaeda, the CIA, and apparently President Obama, Christians are now persona non grata, and it does not matter what country the Christians are from. Coptic children are forcibly being taken from their families and forced to convert to Islam. Is this a foreshadowing of a future CPS field manual which will do the same here in America? Do you think this hyperbole? Then you must not be familiar with the new Child Protective Services manual, which will be used to enforce child welfare under Obamacare. Under Obamacare, parents can lose custody of their children if their child gets a bad grade, is absent for more than 5 days in any 30-day period, if the parent has beer in the house, or if the parent is a gun owner. Therefore, how far-fetched is it for American Christians to look at themselves as the next Coptic Christians and realize that the CPS could one day come for their children merely because they're Christians? Why Christians? Humanity is locked in a spiritual war, although it is true that we must meet the enemy at the gate if we are to survive, and that entails some use of physical countermeasures. However, physical realm countermeasures can only delay the inevitable. Spiritual warfare demands spiritual solutions. Rather than repeat myself, I would refer the reader to previously identified spiritual strategies in two articles I recently authored, Harnessing Quantum Entanglement is Humanity's Secret Weapon and Humanity's Ultimate Weapon. The concepts are scientifically verifiable and simple enough to understand, and more importantly, they work. After reading about the spiritual weapons that mankind has at its disposal, it should be obvious as to why Christians are being targeted and being attacked with such a vengeance. The ultimate enemy of humanity is not Al-Qaeda, the Russians, the central bankers, and not even Obama himself. The ultimate enemy of humanity is Satan, the great destroyer, and the aforementioned groups merely serve him. These forces of evil have conscripted vast resources in the march toward enslaving and depopulating humanity. They control the physical realm. Humanity cannot defeat these forces of evil on the physical battlefield. Humanity is approaching its metaphorical Lexington and Concord. The central bankers are seeking to disarm humanity by eradicating the Christian threat to their agenda. You see, the dark side already knows what most of us don't yet realize. Christians have the spiritual weapons to defeat those who are destroying humanity. It's up to you, up to me, and up to all of us to invoke the use of these spiritual weapons. Some articles write their own conclusion, and this is one of those times. In 1892, the Supreme Court determined and declared the United States was indeed a Christian nation. In 1952, President Truman established a day a year as a national day of prayer. In June of 2007, then-presidential candidate Barack Obama declared that the USA was no longer a Christian nation. This year, Obama canceled the 21st annual National Day of Prayer ceremony at the White House under the ruse of not wanting to offend anyone. But on September 25th, 2009, from 4 a.m. until 7 p.m., a National Day of Prayer for the Muslim religion was held on Capitol Hill beside the White House. There were over 50,000 Muslims in D.C. that day. He prays with the Muslims. I guess it doesn't matter if Christians are offended by this event. They obviously don't count as anyone anymore. The direction this country is headed should strike fear in the heart of every Christian, especially knowing that the Muslim religion believes that if Christians cannot be converted, they should be annihilated. Newsflash, pea brains. The skinny, effeminate male impersonator in the White House does not have, nor do any of you have, the authority to declare this nation anything other than what it was created and founded to be, a constitutional republic. Why? Because you, none of you, are the bosses. We are. If and when the people of this country see fit to change our form of government, our religious description, our national allegiance, we'll let you know. Meanwhile, we've had enough of your corrupt, self-serving shenanigans. You're not getting our guns. You're not going to silence us. You're not going to continue poisoning us. And you're not going to wage any more wars in our name. Step up, baboons. We the people are waiting for you to register for our draft. You want a war? Any war, okay. As soon as you fight and die, or get lucky enough to return, we the people will vote on whether or not we should join you. Here's an interesting quote. Just look at us. Everything is backwards. Everything is upside down. Doctors destroy health, lawyers destroy justice, universities destroy knowledge, governments destroy freedom, the major media destroy information, and religions destroy spirituality. Dr. Michael Elner. Since it's Constitution Day here in America, we the people would like to take the opportunity to honor the original Americans who drafted and wisely adopted it. Here's to our founders, and we declare on this Constitution Day, September 17th, 2013, that you baboons had better start adhering to it. Because we are the answer.